walk the kingdom within me, but I didn't understand what that was. I always tell you in this church, you don't know who you're crossing paths with. You don't know who God is bringing into your life. It's not just an occasional thing when you're living in the kingdom. God is very intentional. He's very intentional. He doesn't waste his time. You don't know who you're going to meet. Embrace every encounter. Embrace every encounter. Because the word that he spoke over me today, he's been preaching in it for 3 days. So he's eating off of the fruit from a seed that he planted. Amen. Remember that people that you meet, God is doing something in your life. You don't know. But we trust the Lord. We never trust in man. We trust the Lord at all times. Amen. We're going to call up Brother Matias. Here, we thank you for the 3 days, but those are done. So if you don't got something new, brother, don't even come up. Amen. but we want to clap, not for him, but for the God that is in him. Amen. Thank you to the worship team for being here yesterday and just serving in this ministry. Let me pray for him before y'all leave. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you for what you're doing in Brother Matias's life. Lord, help us to partner with this ministry financially, Lord. Lord, from the first day you impressed it on my heart to be financially tied to this ministry because of what he's doing, Lord. The revival events that he's doing on a global scale. Lord, he's winning souls, and that's your goal, is new souls. Lord, but today we just bless him through the name of Jesus, that he preached the word of God today, that he preached the kingdom today, that he preached repentance today, that he preached revival today, Lord. Use him, Lord. Protect his mind. Protect his eyes. Protect his ears. Protect his mouth. Let nothing come out of his mouth that was not predestined for him today and for us. We pray all of this in the mighty, majestic, and miraculous name of Jesus Christ, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Can somebody say amen? Give yourselves a round of applause. What an amazing work. Don't sit down. Stand up. Don't sit down. What an amazing work is being done here. Can you guys give it up for the amazing leadership here, Pastor Brian and you? Because it's coming and the devil can't do nothing about it.
Amen.
I'm going to repeat that. I said it's coming and the devil can't stop it.
Amen.
Can you say amen?
Amen.
Now, I want you to open up your Bibles. I'm going to try to get through this text. I've been trying to do it for the last 4 days and I have not been successful. And so I want you to follow me today. I mean, I got time, right? This is an early morning, so that means I got time.
Jesus, we love you, Lord. Jesus, okay? We magnify the name of Jesus.
And so we're in this time, okay. Now, I'm going to take my time because, this is the thing. I got to leave it all here today. Because they say that I'm going to leave today. I don't know how they going to get me out. But they saying I'm going to leave. So, I want you to go with me, first of all, to 1 John chapter 5, verse 7-9. Okay, we're going to read that very quickly just to give you a foundation. That's my foundational verse for this series. Somebody say, God is my witness.
Is my witness.
Okay, now, this is, this is key. Now, I'm going to read that, and then I got a couple more verses I want to read just to kind of give you some direction. All right? So we'll start there. Verse 7 says, "For there are three that bear witness." Somebody say witness.
Witness.
Witness. Okay. In heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Spirit. And these three are one. These three are what?
One.
And there are three that bear witness on earth: the Spirit, the water, and the blood. And these three agree as one. If we receive the witness of man, this is what I want to develop today. Somebody say the witness.
The witness
of man.
Of man.
Okay, okay. Repeat that again. Say the witness.
The witness
of man.
Of man.
The witness of God is greater. Why is this important? Because man does not know the ways of the Spirit. Man does not understand the ways of the Spirit. The Bible says they are foolishness unto them, unto him. He doesn't perceive. A man looks at you, the Bible says, on the outward. But God sees the heart. Your heart is all of your spirit. Can you say amen?
Amen.
So, man, you got to learn how to not listen to what people are saying in the flesh. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Okay, can you say amen?
Amen.
Now, the first person you don't ever listen to is your own flesh. Now go somewhere. If we receive the witness of man, if you dare believe a man, the witness of God is greater. For this is the fire of his child. So meaning God is witnessing only for children. Can someone say amen?
Amen.
Now, somebody say witness.
Witness.
Now, I want to teach you this. Go with me now to Isaiah 8:18. Now go with me to Isaiah 8:18. Now I'm gonna go through this in my spirit because I gotta develop this. Okay. I want everybody to stay cool, calm, and collective, and take notes. Isaiah 8:18. This is my last verse. Isaiah 8:18. Behold, here am I, and the children whom God has given me. Somebody say the children.
The children.
Wait a minute. Somebody say the children.
The children.
Now notice what he said in John. And that this is the testimony that God has given of his. Of his, God only testifies about children. He only speaks on, because see, God don't look at you like people look at you. Amen. See, here am I, this is Jesus in the Old Testament speaking. Here am I, and the children whom the Lord has given me. for. We are for. Come on, you guys gotta talk to me. We are for. Signs and wonders in Israel from the Lord of hosts who dwells in Mount Zion. Okay, lift up one hand. Lift it up high. Lift it up high. And repeat with me, say, Lord.
Lord.
You got to say it with authority like you're a sign. Say, Lord.
Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I accept.
I am.
A sign.
And a wonder.
To my generation.
In Jesus' name.
Now say out loud, amen.
Amen.
All right, you may be seated. Okay, now open up your heart. Open up your heart. Because God's going to bring you somewhere, okay? And take notes. All right. So I gotta show you what is going on here. I want to talk to you for a couple minutes under the title, The Enemy. Is a false witness. Okay, so just one person got it.
Yes.
The enemy is a false witness.
Yes.
Okay, I'm gonna repeat that till you get it. The enemy is a false witness.
Amen.
Somebody say the enemy.
The enemy
is a false witness.
It's a false witness.
Okay. Now. The devil has always been after God's glory. I'm going to take my time today, okay? So I want to show you what's the problem in the spirit realm. The devil has always been after God's glory. The moment that corruption was found in the enemy, was because he wanted what only God possesses. He wanted the glory. Somebody say the glory.
The glory.
Okay, somebody say the glory.
The glory.
The Bible says that in Ezekiel, the devil said in his heart, I will ascend to the mountain of God. And this is the catch. I will ascend to the mountain of God. He's already in a high place. But it's not enough for him. He says, I will ascend to the mountain of God. And this is what he says. And I will be like the Most High. What makes him the Most High is that everybody gives the glory to him. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Everybody gives the glory to God. And so the devil has always been after the glory. This is why. Because in the glory, everything changes.
Preach, man of God.
Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
In the glory, everything changes. That's why the devil, see, God's glory makes anything that gets in his presence change. Can you say amen?
Amen.
I'm going to show you something. The Bible says that they put the rod in the most holy place, in the rod that was dead from one day of being in the glory, it was transformed into a rod that budded. Can you follow what I'm saying? It was transformed into a rod that budded because in the glory, everything changes. That's why the devil wanted the glory because, see, the glory has no limits.
It's okay. You got game.
No, can you say amen?
Amen.
Okay, look. Can you say amen?
Amen.
I'm going to show you some stuff today. Somebody say the glory.
The glory.
Say it with authority. Say the glory.
The glory.
Has no limit.
Has no limit.
See, the Bible says
the glory. So now, everything else has to draw from God. God doesn't draw from no one. Can you say amen?
Amen.
And so he lives in the glory. And so what the enemy wanted was the ability to be able to operate in a place that he didn't have to draw from anything. He wanted to be like God, and he wanted to operate in that same manner. He didn't want to depend on God. Can you say amen?
Amen.
And so God demoted him. God demoted him, and he lost everything. And the glory that he always wanted, because he went about it in the wrong way, he went about it in the rebellious way, God said, I'm not going to give it to you because your heart is not right. See, God cannot give you the glory, and he cannot put the glory that he dwells in if your heart is not like his heart.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
See, what the enemy did not understand is that you, to have what God possesses, you got to have the heart that God has. Can you say amen?
Amen.
And so he tried to go about it. Watch this. He tried to go about it by force instead of by spirit. He tried to go about it by force. The Bible says it's not by power and it's not by might. He tried to do it in his own power instead of asking God to teach him.
You know, oh God, you got my brother.
Instead of asking God to teach him how to be like him, he said, you know what? I know better, and I can get there by myself without the power of God. That's what mankind, is dealing with. It's the same thing that we try to get to a place of glory. We try to get to a place of power, but we're trying to do it independently of God because that's the nature of the enemy. Are you hearing what I'm saying? And so the enemy wants you to behave in that manner. Why? Because anybody that depends on God, watch this. Somebody say depend.
Depend. Oh God.
Somebody say depend.
Depend.
On God.
Lift them up.
I'm saying to you some stuff that if you get, your whole life is going to explode.
Come on.
Somebody say, Lord.
Lord.
Say it out. Lord.
Lord.
Teach me.
To depend.
On you.
On you.
Now watch this. The dependence on God would have guided the enemy what he was seeking for. But he tried to get it independently. See, the difference, listen, the difference between the enemy's way is that he's trying to get to the place of God without depending on God. And God is saying, no, I don't want you to get there without me because you don't know how to handle that level. I'm going to teach you how to have my heart so that when you get there, you know how.
Preaching.
That's the nature of the enemy. The nature of the enemy is independence. Somebody say independence.
Independence.
The nature of Jesus is surrendering. Somebody say surrendering. Now watch this. Anybody that surrenders to God, he gives his glory to. I said anybody that surrenders to him, he gives the glory to. So what he was looking for, God said, I would have given it to you had you came to me and asked me. But you try to do it independent and is trying to grab it in the wrong way. You lost everything instead of surrendering and coming to me humbly. You're not ready for this. Instead of surrendering and coming to me humbly, I would have given you more than. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
No. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Somebody say, let it loose.
Let it loose.
No. Somebody say, let it loose.
Let it loose.
Now, I'm about to teach you something that the Lord has revealed to me. You know what? Listen, you can never ask God for something that's too big for him to give you. Really get that. Go with me to Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20. We're almost preaching.
Flow.
Is it okay?
Yes.
Amen.
Ephesians 3:20. I need my crew in the back to be ready. Notice what the Bible says. I want you to get this. Now to him who is able to do. I need you to talk to me. Who's able to do? Abundantly above that we can. So what the devil was asking was actually small for God. I said what he wanted was small, but he didn't know it. If he would have came with the right spirit, God said, is that all you want?
Yes.
Let me teach you something about God. measure and for you and me to be like him.
Glory.
Everybody, one, two, three. In the glory which you gave me, I have given
them. Let's read it again.
And the glory which you gave me, I have given
them. Wait a minute. Read it again.
And the glory which you gave me, I have given
them. Now notice the purpose of the glory. What's the purpose?
That they may be.
One. Wait a minute.
That they may be.
One.
Just as we are.
One.
So the glory unites. It doesn't divide. The devil went about getting the glory by division. When you really have the glory of God in you, you love everybody. You need them. When you really have the glory, you know why some of us cannot handle everything that God wants to put on you? Because our heart still is not big enough. Your heart is not big enough. You don't love enough yet. If God put you where you really belong and gave you a couple dollars and put that business where it really belongs, you say, you know what, forget about you, because I'm on another level. Your heart has to be ready for the height that he wants to give you. Somebody say, my heart has to be ready
to be
in the glory. But you were thinking about a person that you can't stand on your way to church. You were thinking about a person you can't stand on your way to church. And God is saying, you can't be in the glory. Watch this. You can't be in the glory if you don't have the capacity in your heart to love every single person. Watch this. And not get offended with anybody. And not get offended. If you're still getting offended, the glory is too much for you. So God says, keep them at the bottom until she's ready to be up. Do not allow them to go all the way to where they have to go. Because if you allow that to happen, they're not going to be able to handle it. Can you say amen?
Amen.
So God's desire is to give you the glory. But how does he give you the glory? Watch this. By putting glory in you. Where he's going to put the glory?
In you.
Where does he have to put the glory?
In you.
He's going to put it in you. If the glory's not in you, the glory outside will destroy you. So the height that God wants to give you, if you don't have the character inside, will destroy you.
Just the truth. Just preaching truth.
You know, there are some people in your heart. Watch this. There are some people in your life right now that are, watch this, they are glory testers. They are testing you to see. They are testing you to see if you really are ready to go to where God wants to take you. You didn't hear what I said. They are testing you for the kingdom. So if you cannot work with those people now, how are you going to be able to work? If you cannot handle the test God gave you now, and you cannot handle your kids, and you cannot handle your neighbor, you cannot, that's God says, if you cannot handle them, what's going to happen when I give you multitudes to handle?
I repent.
Somebody say, Lord.
Lord.
Go to Colossians 1:27.
Colossians 1, take notes. Watch this.
To them God will to make known what are the riches of the
glory.
What are the riches of the
glory?
What are the riches of the
glory?
So the glory has riches untold. The glory has riches untold, meaning the glory cannot be measured. That's what the devil wanted. He wanted to be without measure, just like God is without measure. He wanted to have no measure. It wasn't enough that he was the archangel. He said, I want to be like him. I don't want to have any limit. And he said, to them, God will to make no one of the riches of the glory. Watch this. Of this mystery. So it is a mystery, the glory. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Watch this. Mystery among the Gentiles, the people that are carnal, that cannot think after that, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. What is the glory? Christ
in you.
What is the glory?
Christ in you.
Wait a minute. What is the glory?
Christ in you.
The glory is Christ in you, the hope of the glory. So what the devil was hoping for, he said, I want the glory. The Lord says, the glory is Christ in you. But he said, I want to do it without Christ. He said, when you left Christ, you left.
Oh my goodness.
When you left Christ, you left the glory. The glory is Christ in you. So the more Christ is in you, the more glory.
Oh my goodness.
The more glory you operate in. Watch this. Somebody comes up to you and they talking you down and they saying this and that and they saying that third and you are that, that, that. And you look at them, watch this. And they look at they step all over you, but you look at them and you want to say 100 things that cross through your mind. But Christ in you said, don't you open your mouth. Why? Because what the devil is trying to do is trying to get you to lose what he lost. To lose the glory. You don't get what I'm saying. To lose the glory that Jesus has put in you. Somebody say, the glory, is on me, and in me. Now say amen.
Amen.
Anytime you stop walking in love, you are distilling glory. Because the glory is Christ in you. Anytime you step out of that, you're losing what God put on you. He says, the glory you have given me, I have given to them. The way for you to walk in the glory, the way for you to step into all that God has for you. You know what the glory is? Where there's no need. There is no need in your life. There is no need in your mind. There is no need in your emotions. There is no need in your... You don't hear what I'm saying. The Bible says, now unto him that's able to do exceedingly and abundantly. He wants to do exceedingly and abundantly above all you can ask or think. Why? He says, I'm in the glory. There is nothing you can ask that's too big for me. I want to put you in a place where there is no need in your mind. There is no need in your emotions. There is no need in your heart. You know why there's so many problems? Because somebody got a need. I'm needing this. I'm needing that. And what? You know what we do? We put the need that we have on people. And people cannot supply your need. You didn't hear what I said. People cannot supply your need. So what I do is, nobody wants to understand. And nobody wants to clap for this. Because this is why. It's okay that you don't listen. I'm going to tell you the truth anyways. Because the only one that can supply your need, his name is Jesus. I want to give you something. Watch this. There is not a single day. My wife is right there. Watch this. My wife is right there.
This is my lovely wife. Her name is Lydia Rojas. And there's not a single day in our 8 days of marriage that I've been upset at.
8 years. 8 years.
8 years. I said, wait a minute.
I'm like, he's living in God's time.
I said, wow. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. We've been married for 8 years. She's right here. Listen, when you have her by yourself, I want you to confirm that what I'm saying. There's not a single day that I've been upset at her. You know why? Because she cannot supply my need. You know when you get upset at somebody? When you have an expectation on them that only God can supply. You can go. It's mad. You're mad at your husband and you're mad at your wife because you're trying to get them to do something that only God can do. You hear what I said? Only God can supply your need.
Flow, man of God. Flow.
Can you say amen?
Amen.
Now watch this. Hit the man. Hit the mark. God's intent for all of his creation is to experience his glory. So that you know what happens when somebody enters into the glory? They stop being a burden. When you enter into the glory, you're not looking to get nothing. You're always giving. You didn't hear that. I said, when you enter into the glory, you're not looking to get nothing because you want something that has supplied all of your life. So when you show up, you don't need nothing. I came to bring something. I need you to get something in your
spirit.
Somebody say, Lord. I want you to see this. Look, listen to this. Everyone, 1, 2, 3. I want you to read this for me. Everyone who is called by my, whom I have created for my glory. Wait a minute.
Wow.
Everyone who is called by my
name.
His name is Jesus. He's the Savior. He's the name that's above every
name.
Now watch this. Everyone who is called by my
name,
whom I have created for my
glory.
The purpose of you being created was to experience the glory of
God.
That's the actual purpose of you being created. Why? Because that means that if you're in the glory, you're never looking to get nothing. You're always looking to get something. Watch this. Anything that comes out of the presence of God doesn't need anything.
I just gave you some. Some of you thinking about it. Like, what kind of theology is this? I'm going
to teach you. I said anything that comes out of the presence of God doesn't need anything. Listen to me. Moses, I'm going to teach you this. To some of you, you know, Moses is 100. Watch this. He's 100 years old. How many years?
100.
He's 100 years old. At this age, given between 90 and 100, he goes up to the mountain of God. And he's with God for 40 days. And this is why he says to God, in the 40 days, now he's seen God open the Red Sea. He's seen God provide manna from heaven, and he's still with God, and God says in the whole time, Moses, what do you want? You're my friend. You're my son. He says, what do you want? And Moses said, I only want one thing. Can you show me your
glory.
I see the Red Sea. I see manna. I see you provide. But the only thing that I need, you didn't hear what I said. The only thing that I want to see is I want to see your
glory.
Watch this. And so God looks at him and said, that's a hard thing. Nobody can see my face. He dwells in the glory. Nobody can see my face and live. Meaning, if I show it to you openly, you're going to die from the impact. You didn't hear what I said. And so he says, instead of showing you my glory directly, I'm going to hide you in a rock. And when I hide you in a rock, I'm going to pass by you. And then I'm going to let you get out. And you're only going to see my back. You didn't hear what I said. And when you see, you guys are not going there. And when you see my back, that's going to be enough. Now Moses hides under a rock. God comes down from the cloud, shows up. And when he looks at him, he looks at his back. The impact was so strong that Moses came down from the mountain and he did not know his face is glowing. His face is glowing with the glory of just from seeing. Now watch this. Now he's 120. How old is he now? How old is he now? You didn't hear what I said. How old is he now?
120.
He's 120. You know what God says to him? He says, Moses, go up to the mountain and die. God had to command them to die because that one time that he saw that glory was keeping him from aging. You didn't hear what I said. So God is saying to him, go up to the mountain and die. There's some of us taking vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin C, vitamin. I'm telling you, take vitamin G-O-D. And that won't be enough so that you're not getting sick.
Go.
Stop.
Yo,
please stop, man. Come on.
Keep going.
Vitamin G, O, D.
God had to command him to die because he wasn't aging from seeing the glory. He was not aging. And God said, Moses, you're already 120. Go up to the mountain and die. Saw something on your back, you better rebuke the devil and tell him, I'm filled with the glory. I'm telling you right now, if we only took advantage of what God has given us, you will be a sign to the world that God is still alive. Somebody say, I'm a sign.
I'm a sign.
No. Somebody say, I'm a sign.
I'm a sign.
Say it now. Say, I am a sign.
Just from watching the glory for a couple minutes,
so he said, wait a minute, I don't want to go back down to the normal people. I don't want to go back down. And people say, why Peter God act so foolish and God had to come out and say, this is my beloved son and whom I'm well pleased. Listen to him. You know why Peter was saying that? Because Peter said, while I'm over here looking, I don't know if anybody, James, John, did you get that? You remember that back day I told you about in the bottom of the mountain? Ever since I've been looking at the glory, I don't feel no pain anymore. You know what I'm saying? And he said, do you remember that barefoot that you had since I've been in glory? That thing left. And so he said, forget about going back down. Let's stay up here. Stay in the glory. Here am I in the children whom the Lord has given me. We are for signs and wonders. In other words, he said, we are for the glory of God. When you are a sign and a wonder, you are operating in the glory of God. Jesus' assignment was not to give you a house. Jesus' assignment was not to give you a car. That's not his assignment. That's too small. He came back and he said, I'm going to give you what Adam lost. I'm going to give you back the glory. I'm going to give you back the glory so you can be a sign and you can be a wonder again. Go with me to Hebrews chapter 2 verse 10. Hebrews 2:10. Watch this. Hebrews 2:10. Listen. Hebrews 2:10. Start on verse 9. I want you all to read this with me. 1, 2, 3. But we see
Jesus,
who was made a little lower than the
angels,
for the suffering of
death,
crowned with
glory.
Crowned with
glory
and
honor,
that he by the grace of God might taste death for
everyone.
So he's saying, the only way for me to give you the glory again, I have to take what you got for you to get what I got. So that's why, which is, what I said, the glory is so strong on Jesus. Somebody say the glory.
The glory.
Somebody say the glory.
The glory.
The glory is so strong on him, Pastor. See, that the Bible says they whipped him 39 times. They put a crown of thorns on his head. His flesh is open and his veins are popping out. They bring him to the cross and they put nails in his hands. They put nails in his feet. He's supposed to bleed to death just from that. He's hanging on the cross, watch this, for 6 hours and he's not dead yet. Why? Because though he's torn on the inside, on the outside, the glory's on the inside. And so the devil knows he can touch anything, but he cannot touch the
glory.
So until he says it is finished, he will not die.
Oh my God.
Until he said it is finished, he will not die. Why? Because the glory inside of him would not allow him to die. He will still be hanging there till this day. Oh my goodness. Until he said it is. If you only knew what you are. Somebody say, I'm a sign.
I'm a sign.
And I'm a wonder.
And I'm a wonder.
I'm puzzled about how we get all upset. And this, why are you upset about? I got a headache. Are you kidding me? You have the glory. God inside. God's glory is in you. We see Jesus made a little lower than the angels for the suffering of God, crowned with glory and honor. While death is all around him and cannot touch him because he's still crowned with
glory.
And the death angel says, I want to take him, but I can't. The glory's up. And he's going all around the cross, but he can't touch him. Oh my goodness. And he's going over there and says, I want to do it. And the devil said, take him out. He said, I can't. Say for everyone. Now listen to verse 10. I want everybody to get verse 10. Somebody say verse 10 is my deliverance. Say it loud. Say verse 10 is my deliverance. Everybody, 1, 2, 3. For it was fitting for whom all things and by whom are all things in bringing many sons to
glory.
In bringing many sons to and bringing many sons to
glory.
So God was not bringing you to your house. He was not bringing you to your car. He said, the only reason I'm here is because I'm bringing you back to the
glory.
Yes. I receive it. I receive it in the name of Jesus.
Here am I and the children who God has given me. We are for signs and
wonders.
You are supposed to be a sign and a wonder. And the only reason the enemy's fighting you is because the very thing you got was what he was fighting for. The very thing you got was what he was fighting for. And that's why he can't stand you. And that's why he's trying to take your kids out. And he's trying to take your spouse out. And he's trying to get your wife. And he's trying to get your money. Because he says, every time I look at you, I remember what I lost. You
can...
oh. Every time I see you.
I lost the glory because I stopped depending on God. Do the same thing and you're going to be in the same place I was many years ago. You don't hear what I'm saying. I'm telling you right now, if you take this in your spirit, it's going to break out and you're going to become a sign to the world. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Say, Lord.
Lord.
Wiser than you act, there's only one thing that he's doing. He's trying to get you to believe what God never said. Watch this. Because that's how he lost the glory. He wants you to believe the witness of a man over the witness of God. He wants you to take what men are saying over what God has said. All of this is yours right now. Somebody say it's mine.
It's mine.
I didn't hear you. Somebody say it's mine.
It's mine.
It's yours right now. And the devil wants you to behave all bound up. He wants you to come to church and keep your mouth closed. He wants you to be getting upset at people. He wants you to lose your love. He wants you to lose your forgiveness. Because that's the same way he lost the
glory.
everything that's happening in your life is for one purpose, trying to get you to lose what he lost.
I want somebody to get this in their spirit.
That's the purpose. He's trying to get you to lose what he lost. He lost the glory. In the glory, there is no need. He lost that. He lost it. And now he's trying to get in your heart so you lose it as well.
This is how it works. I'm telling you,
the enemy is a false
witness.
The enemy is a false
witness.
So he's trying to tell you you're sick when the glory says you are
healed.
Watch this. The glory only responds to your level of consciousness of it. The glory only responds to the level of consciousness. If you start behaving like you're all weak and you're broken down, the glory's inside, but it can't help you because you won't let it. You won't let it help you. Moses, go up to the mountain and die. Why? Because the glory kept him alive. Somebody say, I'm not concerned. Say it with authority. Say,
I'm not concerned
about anything. Glory to glory.
Wait a minute,
from glory to
glory.
So you're not gonna get the glory. You're in it, and you're gonna go to another level. Now, from glory. next to you, behave like it.
Behave like it. Behave like it.
Behave like it. Stop being so grumpy. And stop, and all got a face. That's the people in the grumpy, they always got a smile on their face. Watch me. I always got a smile on my face. You say, why are you smiling? I'm in the glory of God. I'm in His glory, and I'm going to. Say amen. Somebody say,
I am.
A sign.
In God.
Is my witness. What you gotta do with false witnesses? What you gotta do with false witnesses? 7 things you gotta do with false witnesses. Give them to me. Let me give them to you real quick. I'm leaving. How many times did I leave? Careful, because we see something and right away, this is what we do. We're saying what we see instead of saying what God said. I want you to live here. I want you to leave this place glory conscious. I want you to leave here what? In the glory there is no
need.
No need. In the glory there is no
need.
In the glory there is no
need.
That's why the Lord says, I shall supply all of your
need
according to my riches and
glory.
So in the glory there is no
need.
So anything you got on your body that's a need, the glory can fix it. Anything that you have in your body that's a need, the glory can
fix it.
Amen.
Amen.
I'll come back and I'll break that down more. But watch this. We are going from glory to
glory.
What you do with a false witness is you don't consent. In other words, stop sinning. What you gotta do?
Stop sinning.
What you gotta do?
Stop sinning.
What you gotta do?
Stop sinning.
Stop sinning. Why? Because that's in that kingdom the devil has authority. In that kingdom the devil has
authority.
Let me teach you how you're supposed to live. 1 Peter 3:13. We are supposed to be, listen. I'm the happiest person in life. I'm telling you. Listen. Everybody, 1, 2, 3. And who
is he?
Who will? If you follow what is
good. We did it again.
And who is he that will? If you become followers of what is
good.
We did it again. And who is he who will harm if you become followers of
what
is? That's a question to all of the universe. God said, who will harm you if you're with me? That's what he's asking. Who will harm you if you're with me? And we are afraid of this, and we are afraid of that. My foot hurt. This. God's with you. You know what he said? You know what's the revelation that Jonathan got? He said, I've noticed this. God is able to save by many or few. He's able to do what? Save by many or a
few.
This is how you're supposed to live, saints. Do not believe the false witness. Do not believe the false witness.
Go with me to 1 John chapter 5 verse 18.
1 John chapter 5 verse 18. Everybody, watch this. 1, 2, 3. We know that whosoever is born of God does not
sin.
But he who has been born of God keeps
himself.
And the wicked one does not
touch
him. Stop talking about that you're going to die. Let me tell you something. You can't die. That's the devil's kingdom. The Bible says right here, he who has been born of God does not
sin.
Does not
sin.
But keeps him. Stop trying to say, God, hold me and keep me and bind me so I won't sin. The Bible doesn't say that. The Bible says you keep yourself. And the wicked one does not
touch
it. Everybody, and the wicked one does not
touch
it. Again, and the wicked one does not
touch
it. Stand on your feet.
Listen to me. If you want to walk in the glory, and you're not going to believe the false witness, I want you to come up here quickly. Come here. Come running up here really quick. Come. Come to the altar. Come to the altar really quick. Really quick. Come. Come to the altar. Run up here. Run up here. Don't look at anybody. Just run.
Thank you.